Despite his busy schedule, he was there with us for the whole day. Now I request on special guest Tenzin Selekle, director of TCV, to please come up on the stage and address the gathering. He's already on the stage. Please come here on the desk, sir, and address the gathering.
Tashi Delay, you may be wondering why I have been sitting here since morning till now. Okay. Let me introduce a little bit about myself. My name is Tenzin Selek, and I was brought up by Tibetan Children's Village School when I was 4 or 5 years old. And then I completed my schooling in TCV schools, and then I went to college, and then all my life I was a teacher. And for 38 years I've been serving. Now I'm working as the education director of all TCV there. So it's indeed a great pleasure and honor to be here today. And Madam Principal, you have started this function. I mean, like, today's a foundational literacy numeracy. You have started in such a way that we all here got excited. And even me, even though I have lots of work there, I had to stay here. So earlier this morning, prior to coming here, I was interacting with the senior students at school. And I have been interacting with them, and they have asked so many questions, all been touched here. So today, what I want to say is, I wasn't a monk. I'm a new monk, novice monk. Recently, I received Gelong Dongpa from His Holiness the Dalai Lama. And with that, I want to really bless you all here, especially school, Maha Bodhi Residential School. I bless you all, and you are doing a job that every sentient being on this earth needs to do. Because why? Because I've been listening to all the panelists here, and this morning what Professor Sandorampa said, what we need to do and what we need to think and what we need to really embody in ourselves is, who are we talking about when we say children? Some of you have touched. He said, children are not mine. Children are not yours, as prophet. In prophet, he says, they have come through us. And they get how many? Scientifically speaking, they have 23 chromosomes come from father, 23 chromosomes come from mother. It's a mixture. And those who believe in life after death all have come from what? Imprint of the past. So that's why I'm saying, in Tibetan we have a saying, Buddha nature, Tathagata Gaba. Every individual, even we say all sentient beings, all the human beings, even child, have that Buddha nature. The education is duty, parents' duty is to tap that. And suppose if you have a seed, apple seed and the wheat seed, you sow it in a soil, nutritious soil, it grows up. Which one will grow faster? Of course, within 3-4 days, you'll grow faster. However, apple will take about 10 years. But we shouldn't compete. We shouldn't say, see, wheat tree, you have to grow because, no, apple tree, you grow because you photosynthesize, I photosynthesize, you have to grow. So never, ever, in the past, what happened? Rote learning, competition. So we have to do away with the competition. As one of the panelists said, children, they have all the knowledge within themselves. Only the environmentally we have to create a phenomenologically speaking environment. However, if we are not careful, because whatever systems you have, education system, how excellent it may be, unless and until you understand children, as Jean Piaget, one of the educationists, said, schema, they form schema, they come to school with their own background. One of the panelists said, children are like a blank paper. a little disagree with that, because we have a past life, all the information happened. However, we pounce upon them. So, all the educationists here, I bless you all. I'm really, what if I touched all the educationists here, because today CBAC has, you know, in 2000 launched new education policy, and the essence is child-centric, competency-based, creativity-rhythm, 21st century learning. There's a 5C, 21st century learning: creativity, critical thinking, communication, collaborative learning, and of course, what? Character. So with that, and that collaborative, and compassion is the essence. If you have a compassion, because one of the panelists here touched about inclusive education, and you have watched the video, and someone who's really struggling, someone with so-called mentally, in a structurally damaged, were able to reach to the stage where we all supposed to be a normal person rich. So why that happened? Because of compassion. So teacher needs to have love for children, compassion, no competition, believing in Buddha nature, and do your job. And I think we all will have a world that will, where, you know, it will promote inclusiveness and love and compassion. And this is what the modern world needs. Not outside, five sense organs are all outside, but we have to delve inside and help these children to tap what we call Buddha nature. This is what I have to say, and thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Lee. Thank you, Sir Lee. It was such a wonderful words to hear from you. Thank you. It means a lot. Every word you spoke have a great meaning for all of us. Thank you for such a joyful session. Thank you. Now, before we move forward, I would like to request chief guest of this session, Chief Education Officer Sir Lee, to please address the gathering. Sir Dorje Namgelle.